In this video, we're going to turn a monochrome image of the sun and colorize it to a more familiar yellow-orange tint, and we're going to use a simple Python script to do it. The script itself is not doing any kind of AI or using any kind of image analysis, so it's pretty dumb. But being dumb makes it really fast. It's a single command line that can colorize a single image or a full directory of images. It does a curves adjustment, followed by an unsharp mask to every image. Everything the script does can be translated into Photoshop actions, which can also be applied to a single image or multiple images. But I thought being able to script it was kind of fun, and it even simplifies the process even more. The images that I'm working on are outputted from AutoStacker, but they can be outputted from any software. So let's take a look at where to download the script and how to run it through a quick demo. So you can get the Python script from this GitHub repo called H-Alpha Solar Colorizing. It's not the best name, but this is what I called it. And you can either clone this entire repo by going to code, getting the HTTPS link or the CLI link and copying it all over, or you can also right-click on the Python file and save link as and just save that. You can also click on this, you can copy and paste it. There are lots of ways, and you can also click on download raw file here. The one thing you need to do before you can run this is make sure that you have the dependencies ready. You can do this in a virtual environment, or you can do it just as is by doing pip install r requirements.txt. So you can run that to install everything automatically, or you can go into the requirements and see what the dependencies are and then install them one by one. So those are the only two dependencies that you'll need. And there are some usage information in this README. So Python, you'd run Python process sol.py, and then you do the I flag for input. So you can do an individual file or an entire directory. I'll do both just to show you what that looks like. And you have some examples here, and it's pretty straightforward. So I'm just gonna do a quick, just gonna go here. I'll click on the download. Oops, all right. Downloaded randomly somewhere, so I'm just gonna copy and paste that into my directory here. So I have some TIFF files that have come out of AutoStacker here as examples from different sessions, different recordings, and we can quickly go through some of them. So this is what this looks like. If you watch some of my Lunt 40 videos, these are the exact same ones. This is unsharpened, sharpened. So yeah, so these are just the different versions of what we see. So we'll get different results. And you know, it's really hard to try and get everything to look amazing all the time, especially when you're trying to automate something without using any kind of AI. So, but I'm gonna try and see what this looks like. And the idea is that if I wanna do a mass conversion, this would be a really easy way to do it. Of course, I can set up Photoshop actions and do that there as well, but this is just for fun. So I'm here. You need to open a command prompt, so you need to make sure that your Python works in that command prompt. So I use Node.js command prompt, but you can use just regular command prompt or PowerShell. If you're on Mac or Linux, you can use Bash or whatever you're comfortable with. And I'm going to switch to my H directory, and then it's going to be the colorizer directory. And we have all of these files. So according to the README, what I need to do is do Python process sol I, and then put the file or directory. So I'm going to do just one of these. So I'll do Python process sol I input, and then I will do sure. This is going to be the first one here, and then I can press OK. There you go. It applied it and it saved it as that inside the output directory. So if I open this back up, you'll see there's an output directory. Click on this, and this is the result. So it looks pretty nice, right? So, and we can look at so there you go. So this is the monochrome version, and this is the unsharp mask with the curves done. Pretty easy, right? Okay. So now we want to process everything. So I'm just going to delete this directory, and then I'm just going to process all of this. So the way to do this is Python process sol I, and then you normally put in the directory. So if it was like an image folder, you can do like image. But since it's in the current directory, everything is in the same location as the process sol.py script, I can just do dot, which means do the current directory. And if I press OK, I press enter, it processes them all, and then it gives you an output of what's being saved where into the output directory. And if I go into my output directory, you can see that there are five of these corresponding to the five of the black and white versions here. So if I click on this and I open this, so this is what it looks like. So we can quickly go through some of these. So again, this one was like completely unprocessed in AutoStacker, or was just processed in AutoStacker, not sharpened. So it looks weird. So yeah, you can see that, you know, different sessions have different outputs because the settings were different. So that's the one thing where if you're using different sessions, different settings, it will look different. But overall, I think, like, if you're trying to streamline processing like thousands of images, if you want to do a video, this could be a really easy way to do it. So okay, so I open these side by side. You can see that they are the same ones. And then I can go through them, and then we can do a compare. So this is what it looks like before, I guess after and before. This one. Here's the other one. There we go. You can see the prominence is pretty well. I should still play around with the settings because I think we can do better with this. If you have, you know, suggestions, do let me know. And this is going to be the fifth one. And we're back. There we go. So that was it. Hope this was kind of interesting. Maybe it'll be useful to some people. If you use it, let me know. If you have any suggestions on how to improve this, you can let me know. I'd appreciate it. Thanks for watching.